Hello children. In the last class, I started the civics lesson, our constitution. In that, I explained meaning and importance of constitution as well as constituent assembly and the drafting committee. I told about the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar also. Yes, no children. So, next portion of that lesson only, that is preamble. Preamble means children, it is the our constitution begins with the preamble only. If you turn the constitution means you will get the preamble only in the beginning. How you will get in your textbook about the content text lessons, no children? By seeing this one you will come to know this many lessons you are having. How many lessons are there in history, how many lessons are there in civics, how many in the geography, all the information you will get. Same way, by seeing only the preamble, you will come to know what are the objectives, what is the goal of the Indian constitution, what it contains, all the information briefly you will get. You can say it is the index of constitution also. So, about that one only I am teaching today children. I wrote the main points about the preamble and the meaning of that also. See children. Preamble of the Indian Constitution, about that only all this information. Preamble, its meaning I wrote here, it is a brief introductory statement of set of guidelines which nation is following. See, Constitution is what? It is a fundamental law. It is giving the guidelines to the government as well as to the citizens. Yes, no? So, all this one, the set of guidelines are briefly written. Briefly means shortly. Shortly they are written. It is a short introduction of the constitution. Brief explanation you can say. Followed the meaning of preamble. Brief explanation of the constitution is called as a preamble. Then, who wrote this one? That is Jawaharlal Nehru. Who is it? First Prime Minister of India. He wrote the preamble. So, he is called as a father of preamble. Followed, then, it clarifies the objectives and goals of the Indian constitution. Why they wrote this one? What purpose the preamble is serving? Why means, see, just if you look at the preamble, means you come to know the what are the objectives of the Indian constitution. What is aiming? What purpose they wrote the constitution? All the things briefly you get. Just at the glance you will come to know Indian constitution, what it contains, what is the aim of the Indian constitution, and what is its culture. Everything briefly you get the information. Then, Indian constitution begins with the preamble, just as you did. It is the like how you get the index in the textbook, no? Like that it is. Index begins with the preamble, constitution begins with the preamble. Then it represents justice, freedom, equality, fraternity, and national integrity. All these things you will get in the preamble. Let me explain this one, children. Justice. Justice means we must be equal to everyone. That is called justice. We should not make any discrimination based on the class, religion, rich, poor, like that. That is called justice. Justice, it is equal in everything to the either in the social aspect or economic aspect, whatever it is. Then freedom. Our constitution only given some freedom to the that one it is for the everyone. That one also they wrote briefly, they wrote in the preamble. What are those freedoms? Next is we are having fundamental rights and duties. In that I will explain these freedoms in detail. Next, equality. All are equal before the law. You know, India is a unity is there in the diversity. Everywhere diversity. In all the respects we are having the number of varieties you can see. So, all are equal before the law, that one. Fraternity means universal brotherhood. It is our mythology also you can say, Indian culture you can say, children. We all are thinking brotherhood is called as a fraternity. National integrity. National integrity means we must have the feeling that we all are Indians. Let it be our religion, caste, language, all the things, rich or poor. First, we must say that we all are Indian. That is called integrity. Feeling of oneness is called as a integrity. These all things are included in the preamble today. Just by seeing the preamble only, we come to know what type of India is there and what is its culture. Preamble picture is given in your textbook. I will show it to you. See here. Like this way, in the paragraph it is there. Can you see? All this one, what things I don't know, here are there. Justice, social, economic, political, liberty. Liberty means freedom. Equality, all these things are there, children. You can see. Yes. Next, children, understood, I think, all about the preamble. It is a brief introduction of the constitution. It is written by Jawaharlal Nehru. It contains purpose of creating preamble is clarifying the objectives and the goals of the Indian constitution. What it contains is justice, freedom, equality, fraternity, and national integrity. Now, it is all about the preamble. Next, I will just the silent features of the Indian constitution. What are those? Let me write down the words of them. This one, points you copy down, children. You are not having textbook. If you are writing in any homework book, just by seeing you come to know what teacher explained about this one. Your lesson will be clear for you. Just only listening and keeping this one means you will not get the idea. So you have to write the main points. Okay? Yes. Current features of the constitution. I wrote a number to the now. Let me explain one by one. Written constitution. See, what is nature means? It is written. We written in a book. And it is the lengthiest constitution in the world, children. Already I said this one will be in the brief explanation of the introduction of the constitution. India is a very big country as well as very diverse country. We have to include all the aspects. Because of that, the Indian constitution is very lengthiest one. And for both central government or state government, we are having only one constitution. One constitution only guiding the both central government as well as the state government. And it is powers and functions of the government, and it is giving guidelines for the duties of the government. Because of all these reasons, we are having the lengthiest written constitution. Got it, children? Next one, Republic. Our constitution declared India as a democratic republic. Democratic republic. Republic means what, children? See, in the elections, we have to be told. Among one of us only will become the representative of us. Our MLA MPs are among us only, you know. They are also citizens. We are looking for and we are electing them as a representatives. They are representing the citizens. That is called republic. Democratic asset. Democratic means we are having the democracy government. That is a type of government. Three types are there. Democracy, dictatorship and communist government. That means three types are there. India is having the democratic government. Democracy means it is a government by the people, for the people and of the people. It is for the people only, the government. That government we are having. Our elected people only ruling us. They are making the rules and regulations for us only. By the people means from the people only we are. Of the people. They are ruling for the people. Following to the democracy meaning. From people only the elected members. They are ruling for the people only. And they are making the rules and regulations for the people only. So that is called democratic government. India is called as a democratic republic. Our constitution declared this. Next, fundamental rights and duties. As a human being, to live comfortably in the society, we must have some rights. When you are having right, you have to do some duties also. Both are together on each other. In detail, I will explain in the next chapter of this one. Just I will give a brief explanation of this one. Indian Constitution has given 6 fundamental rights to the people and 11 duties to the citizens. They are written in the Indian Constitution. No one can highlight this one. Every citizen enjoys the 6 fundamental rights and 11 duties. If you are not getting any rights or any disturbance in the fundamental rights, you can go on to Supreme Court. Yes, student? Next one, secularism. That means, see children, in India, thousands of religions are there. Yes, no? But in our constitution, they are not mentioned as a national religion. All religions are equal. There is no discrimination on the basis of religion in our country. Our government or our constitution is treating every religion equally. All are given freedom to perform their, follow their religion, their festivals, their ceremonies, whatever it is. Yes, no? That is called secularism. Secularism means all castes or religions are equal. There is no state religion. That is called secularism. Follow this meaning, children? Next, independent judiciary. See, children, social justice, economic justice, that is most important for the peaceful society. Maintaining peace in the society, the main work is judiciary. In the government organ, 3 organs are present: executive, legislature. Legislature means our parliament, that is making law. Executive, government bodies, government departments, they are executing that law. And judiciary is protecting that law. It will watch who are following the law. If they are not following this, it will punish. So it is also one of the main organs of the government. As it is the main organ of the government, it should function independently. It should not be dependent with any government. So all the judiciaries are, of course, are not depends on any government. Supreme courts are there, high courts are there, district courts are there. They are not belongs to any court, any government, neither central government, nor state government. They are working independently. Then only they can give the justice to each other. If they belong to state government, means they will do the favor for the state government. If they belong to central government, means they may do the favor only for central government. Yes? So possibilities are there. Because of that one, our constitution declared that judiciary is independent. It not belongs to any government. Follow, children? Then, universal adult franchise. Franchise means power to put vote in the election. If you are putting vote in the election, that is called franchise. Adult franchise here. Adult means the person who attained the age of 18 years. If you are completing 18 years, means you are called as an adult. Universal level. Universal means in India, the person, the citizen who is completing 18 years are capable, eligible to put the vote in the election. That is called universal adult franchise. That also mentioned in the constitution. Next one, election system. See, they declare that it is a republic, democratic republic country. There will be no king rules. After the implementation of the constitution, there will be a democracy government. Then democracy government means that they elect the people from the people only. by election. How to help the election? What is the duration of the election? That all are mentioned in the constitution. According to our constitution, every general assembly election will be once in every 5 years. You may be knowing this one, children. After every 5 years, we are having the elections. We are electing the MLAs and then form the government. Majority party will mean the government. Followed, children. These are the main features of the Indian constitution. Yes, only this much is there, children. Next, we are having the fundamental rights and duties. That one, I am taking next class. Second, most of this lesson also. For this one, you take the homework, children. One more thing, children. India is called as a welfare state. What does it mean? I wrote here, state which aims at social and economic security to all citizens is known as a welfare state. See, India is aiming at giving the social justice or social security and economic security to all the citizens, without any discrimination on the basis of caste, religion, skin color, whatever it is. What are those? Social security. See, it is providing equal opportunity in the society. Any job security, jobs are there, means it is for all. It is not mentioning that only this religion can apply for this. Not like that. It is for everyone. How it is providing, means it is for everyone. It is not making any difference in that also. That is called social security. Job, house, all this one we need know in the society to lead the life. That one. Economic security. Food. Ration is giving, means it is for everyone, children. Any cash facilities is giving, means that is also for everyone. It is not making any difference in that. So whatever in the society, for the development of the people, for the comfortableness, comfortable life of the people, what government is doing, it is for everyone. It is thinking that there should be a social security as well as the economic security. Then only people will lead the happy life. That will be called as a welfare state. For our children. Next, for today's session, I wrote a homework here, that is, what is preamble? Can you write? Then, who wrote our preamble? That is, you have to write. Next, children, write the salient features of Indian Constitution. Fourth one, I will write here. What is welfare state? Can you see this, sir? Yes. What is welfare state? Is four question answers in right here. I will give you question answers of this lesson. Okay? I hope you understood all this one, children. Preamble and features of the constitution. Read all these points neatly. Thank you.